exclusive access, top leagues and tournaments, and the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library.
Welcome to the NCAA Baseball Regionals presented by Capital One. Clemson, South Carolina is the site for this one. It's an elimination game between Lipscomb out of the A's sun. The sun is shining today in Charlotte in its final go-around in Conference USA. Chuck held yesterday 1-seed Clemson with the comfortable win with a late pull away from Lipscomb in the first game, and Tennessee got an early lead against Charlotte, never let it get away in an 8-1 final. So Battle of the Orange tonight on ESPN2, and we'll get started with the 49ers and the Bisons. Hey everybody, Tom Hart alongside Kyle Peterson. About what we expected yesterday, Lipscomb with a great pitching performance hung around until late against Clemson. But Charlotte didn't quite get the production they needed from the nation's home run leader. Wind blowing out today could see some of his performance.
Yeah, it's a good place to hit. We saw the exact same thing last night. Kent Fisher's hit 30 this year. That leads all of Division I baseball. Quiet night last night. This wasn't last night, or it wouldn't have been quiet. But 1-for-3 last night, punched out two different times. Not too often he goes a few straight games without hitting one of the seats. But for Fisher, part of a Charlotte offense, it's hit close to 100 home runs this year. So long ball is the way they play. And that was the score on the other side last night, too. Alex Vergara has 5 home runs in the last 2 days. This one caused an insurance claim at one point. They turned around and looked into the parking lot. Hit another one that just went a mere 390 feet. He was a part of a Lipscomb offense that honestly kept him in it for a while yesterday. They're going to need more of that today if they want to advance on.
The winner will move on to take on the loser of tonight's game. And whoever drops this one will start their summer. It's Lipscomb and Charlotte in just 3 minutes and 10 seconds from Clemson, South Carolina.
To them, the whole world looks like an opportunity, one to be seized, built upon, and made better for their sport and the people around it. To student athletes, every opportunity is a chance to change what could be and show the world what opportunity can do.
We should be more sustainable. Amazon Business can steer us toward more sustainable products. I feel good. What's next?
It's a car that runs on positive vibes.
I love people.
Amazon Business, partnering with enterprise leaders for smart business buying.
Follow your nose to football ground! Part of a complete dance break.
If RPMs raise your BPMs, if the open road is an open invitation, then get up and go. Go turn some heads. Go turn a wrench. Go windows down. Go volume up. Go in. Go out. Go off. NAPA has America's largest network of parts and care, here to keep you firing on all cylinders.
Discover the precision and power of a DR trimmer mower. Trim precisely without arm fatigue. Mow where a bladed mower can. The DR has up to 5 times the power of a handheld trimmer, and our durable heavy-duty cord is ideal for the toughest mowing tasks.
Go online to drtrimmer.com to request your free product catalog. DR trimmer mowers are now on sale, and free shipping is in effect. Hurry, this offer won't last. That's drtrimmer.com.
I'm your overly competitive brother.
Check.
Psych. And I'm about to steal this game from you, just like I stole Kelly Carter in high school, huh?
You got no game. Dude, that's a foul!
And now you're ready to settle a score. Game over. And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, well, you can end up paying for all this yourself. So get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem. Yeah, like me.
Thanks, bro.
Take a lap, rookie.
Real mature.
Here's a look at the batting order for the Bisons from Lipscomb, 23-7 in conference play this year, won the regular season and won the tournament. They lead off with Caleb Ketchup, who was magnificent against Clemson yesterday. Reached on an error in the first, ended up hitting a home run in the fifth inning. Had a stolen base. He can do some damage at the top of this lineup. And the lineup, by the way, with 109 home runs, came into the postseason 14th in the country in long balls. By the way, our regional saw 8 home runs yesterday, second most of any regional. Wyatt Hudepohl gets the ball today for the Charlotte 49ers, junior from Cincinnati, 6'4", 220. Family affair today. His sister plays volleyball at Lipscomb, so split allegiances. Here's his 17th start. He's 6-6 with a 4.44.
He's really been their best all year. The transfer from Kentucky, low 90s when it's right. Curveball's key. If he's landing a curveball, the other stuff works. It's a cutter and a splitter behind it for Hudepohl. He was first team all-conference, went 6th in the Conference USA title game. It was his second start in that conference tournament. That got him to this point. Charlotte needed to win the conference tournament to advance. Now they got to win today to keep this season alive.
So here's how Charlotte will line up defensively. 42 double plays on the season and 979 fielding percentage. Jake Cunningham can go get it in center field, and only 13 errors on the left side of the infield between Stallman and Dragom. They have been run on this season. 89 stolen base attempts against the catcher, Caden Hobson. Ready to go. Here's Caleb Ketchup. 2-for-4 with a home run yesterday. And a first pitch, 93 mile an hour fastball misses up. Ketchup's got some pop, 17th home run yesterday. He's drawn 44 walks. And he's hit 17 doubles. 2-0. Hudepohl, first team all-conference. Went 6th in the CUSA title game on short rest. That was after a 100-pitch outing prior to that, so pushed him back a day.
Good early sign right there. Enough confidence to throw the breaking ball 2-1 and enough control to land it and even a count up.
To the left side, third baseman Stallman cuts off the shortstop and gets it there just in time.
Well, Brandon Stallman's the only one who's going to make this play. Dragum's there, but he's not going to have enough time to make the throw. Throws on the run, bang, bang, but he got him by a half stop. Good start for Hudepohl. Started with a 2-0 count, came all the way back to get a weak ground ball.
So here's yesterday's power source, Alex Vergara. KP mentioned it, 5 home runs over his last 2 games. He hit a 455-foot home run yesterday. One of his 3 hits, now sitting at 23 home runs on the year. Junior out of Colleyville, Texas, has an OPS over 1,000. Third team, all-conference. 3 home runs in the CUSA title game. By the way, what a huge advantage for Charlotte. Hudepohl has been their ace during the season and had to go a couple of times in the tournament, as we mentioned. But really, they've got their number one on the mound today in an elimination game.
Talking with Robert Woodard, head coach of Charlotte, before the game, his only concern with Hudepohl was just workload. How much he's had to go throughout the course of the regular season, obviously last week, and that's the very reason he didn't pitch yesterday.
Missed with the breaking ball. 2-2. Shift is on the infield. They got 3 on the left side. And the count goes full.
Austin Knight, the second baseman, all the way on the shortstop side.
Got him looking. 2 down.
I would say confidence level on that breaking ball is pretty high right now, early for Hudepohl. Threw a 2-0 to Caleb Ketchum to steal a strike. Now he comes back 3-2. And I don't know if this is on the swing or if it's on the pitch itself. Must have been on the pitch, because it definitely was not a swing. So ground ball strikeout for Wyatt Hudepohl to start, and a good start.
And a first pitch fastball of 94 into Mason Lundgren, who was hitless yesterday for the Bisons. Four home runs. He's driven in 31. Hudepohl, 2 appearances in the CUSA tournament. A total of 9 innings pitched, 9 runs and 12 hits. But he was touched for 5 home runs. Charlotte lost its opener to La Tech 13-8. Came back to win 5 in a row, including knocking off Dallas Baptist in the championship game. Got to win a doubleheader from Middle Tennessee on Saturday. Did he go? Say did, 2-2. Did that clip Bill McGuire, the home plate umpire, because he just went out and cleaned a clean plate?
I don't think it got him. I think it may have got Caden Hobson, the catcher, a little bit. Bill McGuire, a former catcher.
Swing and a miss on the breaking ball, and that'll do it. Back-to-back strikeouts for Hudepohl. And he works through the first with no issues.
Yes. massage the very, very long boil, basting every 20 minutes to keep it from drying out. And voila.
This is gonna taste all right.
Wendy's Strawberry Frosty is back for the summer, so Tyler has been spending a lot of frosty time outside.
Ooh. What?
Bro, you look like a strawberry.
It'll even out.
Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's. Now open late.
I'm your overly competitive brother.
Check.
Psych. And I'm about to steal this game from you, just like I stole Kelly Carter in high school, huh?
You got no game. Dude, that's a foul!
And now you're ready to settle a score. Game over. And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, well, you can end up paying for all this yourself. So get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem. Yeah, like me.
Thanks, bro.
Take a lap, rookie.
Real mature.
Charlotte coming off of an 8-1 loss to Tennessee. Lone run came on a solo home run from Austin Knight against his former squad. He had two of the team's six hits, top four in the batting order. 1-13. Got to turn that around today if they want to have some success. They'll face senior right-hander Braden Tucker, 6'3", 205. 16th start on the season. He's undefeated, 7-0 with a 3.54 ERA and a whip of only 1.16.
How did you miss the hometown? Brazil, Indiana. That's got to get out there. Indiana transfer. Keep it in the yard. It's not easy to do in this place. Low 90s. Pretty glove side heavy with a fastball. So into lefties, away to righties. It's a Charlotte offense that can strike quick. It's not just Camp Fisher, who has 30 this year. There's four in this lineup with double-digit home runs.
Brazil, vibrant, progressive, and ready. Clay County, Indiana.
Of course it is.
Sally
knows that.
Bisons line it up. They've only turned 36 double plays this season, and they've committed 66 errors. Austin Kelly has not thrown out a base dealer. Have you ever been to Brazil, Indiana?
Have not. No. I mean, it's on the short list, but not yet.
So that's out of Terre Haute.
Paradise.
Blake Jackson will start it off. He's coming off of an 0-3. And he lines the first pitch to left center. Fist pumps for Jackson, and there's a runner on.
On the first pitch fastball, exactly what he got, 91 miles an hour right down the middle. Blake Jackson shoots it out to the left center. Charlotte, the team, doesn't run a lot. But Jackson runs the most, 9 of 12 in stolen bases this year.
Here's Jack Dragom, 282 average and double-digit home run, second-team all-conference. He was on the CUSA tournament team. Second time in the last 3 years Charlotte has been in the postseason. In 21, they played in the Greenville Regional. And Dragom had a really good weekend. Sends this one into right field. Only a blow dryer breeze today. Warm but ineffective, and Dragom flies out to right. And that'll bring Cam Fisher to the plate. Nation's home run leader, Cam Fisher's got 30 of them. 23 of those home runs off of fastballs. Great pitch.
Well, we talked about this last night with Fisher. So Tucker is more heavy glove side fastball, which is in on his hands, and Fisher climbs on top of the plate. Got it with a fastball last night. It feels like that's the place to go after him. Just don't miss out.
Repeated, nothing and two.
Line,
Charlotte 49ers 34-27. Won the CUSA tournament. And this Lipscomb team won the ASUN regular season and the tournament. Dropped their first two games of the tournament. And then came back to win the whole thing. Interesting. Talk about how they arranged the ASUN tournament by seeding. Jeff Forehand was discussing with us. As the ASUN has grown, the division's got a little bit out of whack. And so they do it by RPI, try to protect those high RPI teams. And Fisher goes down swinging on a changeup. Two down.
Brayden Tucker got away with one here, because that is changeup outer third, which is right into the sweet spot of this swing. Fisher just swung right underneath it. If he gets it, it goes a long way, but that's a big strikeout to get the nation's home run hitter with a guy on first base.
Tucker started his college career at Indiana, and he bends one in for a first pitch strike to Cunningham. Tucker's been around the game for a while. His freshman season was 2019. Then, of course, limited action in 20. That was a one-time Big Ten Pitcher of the Week at Indiana in 21. Nothing in two. Swing and a miss, and back-to-back strikeouts after the leadoff man got on. And Brayden Tucker works his way out of any perceived issues. No score through one in Clemson. The NCAA Baseball Regionals are by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Discover the precision and power of a DR Trimmer mower. Trim precisely without arm fatigue. Mow where a bladed mower can. The DR has up to 5 times the power of a handheld trimmer, and our durable heavy-duty cord is ideal for the toughest mowing tasks.
Go online to drtrimmer.com to request your free product catalog. DR Trimmer mowers are now on sale, and free shipping is in effect. Hurry, this offer won't last. That's drtrimmer.com.
I'm your overly competitive brother.
Check.
Psych.
Really? Dude, that's a foul!
And now you're ready to settle a score. And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, well, you can end up paying for all this yourself. So get Allstate.
The GMC Sierra with hands-free driving. It rocks. Or get 0.9% APR plus over 1,200 trade assistance and no monthly payments for 90 days on Sierra 5.3-liter Ecotec 3 V8 light-duty models.
Imagine a place where a cool summer breeze blows and burgers have that smoky, char-grilled flavor. And also the breeze is your car's air conditioner because you're eating at Sonic. New Sonic Griller. Mmm, Sonic!
Welcome back to NCAA Baseball Regionals, presented by Capital One. What a night last night. After chalk pretty much held during the day, the sunset, full moon, things got weird. Ryder took down Coastal 11-10 in 10 innings, their first win since 87. Oral Roberts, another win against Oklahoma State, and Penn beat Auburn.
How about Penn? 6-3 in the 11th, back-to-back-to-back bunts to knock Auburn off. Auburn's got to win today to keep their season alive.
By the way, Coastal with a nice bounce back. Gary Gilmore's team in his 18th NCAA tournament. He had a grand slam in the first inning. Elimination game against UNCW.
Bounce back. Gary Gilmore announced next year will be his last year at the helm.
Line drive for Trace Wilhoit and a base hit to start the second.
One, two, three, first for Hudepaul. Two strikeouts. This one looked like it was a breaking ball that just caught a little bit too much to play. What a bad pitch. It was right down at the bottom of the zone. Wilhoit just put a good swing on it.
Here's Austin Kelly. Hudepaul has struck out two already. He set a school record and Conference USA record with 17 Ks against Old Dominion a couple of weeks ago. 90 over the black to greet Austin Kelly, nothing in one. Hudepaul's with Kentucky in 21. 16 games made one start. Coming out of St. X in Ohio, he was a number two overall prospect in the state. Swing and a miss in the changeup, nothing in two.
No squeeze play yet, but if you had said St. X when Chris Burke was on set,
I know what he wouldn't have.
We'd have had some fireworks.
He wouldn't have smiled.
Well, he got one last night. I saw one. Mike Rooney has some connections, by the way, because he had three separate bucket hats within about a minute and a half with different logos on it.
You fell for that, didn't you? It was the same bucket hat.
Oh.
You just taped a logo to the front. It's all marketing.
Still got connections.
He does. Time squeeze play start today.
Uno. Un in French. One in American.
Austin Kelly was 0 for 3 yesterday. 21 home runs. Part of this barrage of long ball from the Bisons. To school record in long balls. A swing and a miss on the breaking ball. K number three for Hudepaul.
Yeah, three of the first four outs. Breaking ball's been really good so far. And that was the one that Robert Woodard pointed to before the game. So the fastball is always going to play up. You probably see a three or a four in the first inning. May dip down a little as the game goes on. But if he's landing the curveball and able to steal strikes and then get guys to chase late, that is when he's been at his best this year.
Here's Jake Berg, 1 for 4, got hit by a pitch last night. Leads the Bisons, having been plunked 11 times. One ball, one strike to Jake Berg, a throw over. Wilhoit not likely to run, only one attempt all year. Wyatt's Uncle Joe was an Olympic star.
He was a Cardinal.
That's right.
We were there at the same time.
He also went to St. Xavier High School in Cincinnati. Gold medal in the 400 meter relay team, freestyle relay 92 in Barcelona. Gold medal 4x200 in 96 in Atlanta. Did you ever go swimming with him?
No, I did do a cannonball in their pool once though.
Mm-hmm.
Just felt it was the right thing to do. It wasn't during practice or anything, but it was respectful. But
that would have been a little bit disruptive. Runner on the move, and pitch is low and in. The throw to second is dropped. Well, Wilhoit peek back to the plate like it was a hit and run.
Yeah, but they're not going to run a hit and run with two strikes. I'm not quite sure why he was looking. I mean, you're listening. I understand that, but I mean, he's lucky. Front foot probably beat it anyway, but didn't exactly take a direct route either. I mean, he's almost starting to make a turn.
Yeah, he went to Seneca to get there.
That's two Seneca references in 2 days for you.
Mm-hmm. Slice out of play. We got Anderson reference in yesterday. Well, those two guys are going to have some issues later. That's Clemson versus Tennessee. They'll have a long day at the ballpark, and have a big one tonight on ESPN2, 6 Eastern. Foul back again.
That's going to get a little spicy in here tonight. This is going to be fun.
Three home runs on the season for Berg. He's battling. Here's the 3-2. And he looked at it for strike three. Four Ks now for the Charlotte starter, Wyatt Hudepohl.
I think they've all come on this pitch. It's the second time he's thrown a 3-2 breaking ball and got a strikeout with it. This one just freezes Berg. Hudepohl, early returns, man. He looks good. Four of the five outs so far via the punch out.
Parks Bauk had a couple of hits, two of the Bison's 10, senior out of Keller, Texas. Seven homers on the season. Fastball waved at 1-1. Did you do the cannonball from the high dive?
No, it was just offside the pool. Let it sting.
You said he throws a slider and a cutter?
Cutter and a curveball. And a split. Split's kind of what he uses as his changeup. Doesn't have a ton of down, but enough. I don't think we've seen that one yet.
Missed up, 2-2. And down it goes.
All Conference USA right-hander brought the good stuff today. That's five punch-outs in the first two innings for Wyatt Hudepohl. Early Clemson. We're still scoreless.
Research shows people remember heartwarming ads. So to help you remember that Liberty Mutual customizes your home insurance, here's a touching moment.
I want to give you something very special that I wore on my wedding day.
Liberty Mutual customizes your home insurance so you only pay for what you need. I love you, Mom.
I love you, too.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
Almost finished.
Subway just keeps getting better. Break it down, Candace.
They got world-class bakers to develop their tastiest bread yet. This truly makes the Subway Series a dream team. You know about that, Chuck.
Yeah, I was the bread of that team, too.
Try the Subway Series menu. Their tastiest refresh yet. The Subway Series is getting an upgrade. The new number 19, the Pickleball Club. Who knew the Subway Series could get even better?
Me. I knew.
Maybe you should host a commercial then.
Sure, okay. Subway Series just keeps getting better.
Here's a look at the bracket. Clemson and Tennessee tonight on ESPN2, 6 o'clock Eastern. And then a noon start tomorrow. Going to be a hot one today. Feel like a blow-dryer breeze. I promise the folks in the other side of the press box.
Put that in again. That in.
Okay. Well, you didn't comment on it the first time. Shift is on for the lefty Brandon Stallman.
Right. I didn't hear it.
That's true. Off speed to start him off. 8 home runs for Stallman, who went 1-for-4 yesterday. And slices that one down the line, but foul. Stallman from State Fair Community College in Sedalia, Missouri. The last time he went to State Fair.
Ooh, it's been a long time. Did go to the Nebraska State Fair once, but that's because I've been in the State Fair once. Hmm. And it was a long time ago. How's that for a talking point?
Good job. Mm-hmm. Only 6 hours to go. 3 straight Ks for Brayton Tucker out of Brazil, Indiana. And there's one down.
A funky arm angle for Tucker when he comes to home plate. Tucks it right behind his ear before he lets it go. And his fastball had enough carry to get it right past Stallman and foul one down the left field line before. That one a little bit late, swung right under it. All 3 strikeouts are swinging so far.
Here's Austin Knight, 2-for-4 with a home run. And Charlotte's lost to Tennessee. Senior from Jacksonville. Started his career at Tennessee. And a line drive knock. Second hit of the game for Charlotte.
A two-seamer's going to have arm-side runs, so come back into the right-handed hitter, and Austin Knight does a good job. Staying on it. Belt-high fastball shoots it out to left.
Here's Caden Hobson. I've got the background of Brazil, Indiana, you're hoping for. Yep. Braden Tucker's hometown. Got some big names out of relatively small town. Joe Dean talked about string music in the SEC for a long time. But pick amongst the most famous of these next two. Jimmy Hoffa or Orville Redenbacher?
Oh, popcorn. I hope I don't get my knees taken out for saying that, but yeah, I'd still go Orville on that one.
Plus, he wore a bow tie. It's the 0-1 to Hobson. To the right side, ranging Coppedge. No play at second. 2 down. And Will Butcher coming up. A slow start offensively to this game. Hudepohl has looked great. Tucker is doing his job.
Just one play right here for Coppedge, like he said. All the momentum taking him there, so Charlotte's got one in scoring position. Yeah, I mean, what do we got, 3 singles so far? That's the only offense?
So what's the number that wins this game?
6.
All right. Kind of feels like first team to get in the bullpen will win it. Breaking ball in for a strike to Will Butcher.
Bunch of slackers on squeeze play, by the way.
Sleeping in?
Yeah, I mean, come on. Let's get this thing going.
It's not like there's not a lot of games on. Foul territory, Lundgren in front of the dugout. No runs, a hit, one left for the second consecutive inning. Only 10 pitches needed for Brazil's Braden Tucker.
To them, the whole world looks like an opportunity, one to be seized, built upon, and made better for their sport and the people around it. To student athletes, every opportunity is a chance to change what could be and show the world what opportunity can do.
Wingstop has 12 flavors of chicken sandwich. In my day, we had one flavor, chicken. Now they have a garlic parmesan, a mango habanero, and a lemon pepper. Given the flavor at Wingstop.
And Doug.
What do we always say, son? Liberty Mutual customizes your car insurance.
So you only pay for what you need.
That's my boy. And you get out there and you make us proud, huh?
I don't believe
it. Stay off the freeways.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
You want it? Yo, nah, 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 nah. Come and get it.
This Friday, summer belongs to the bees.
Let's go, baby! One, two, three!
Transformers Friday.
Third inning on a hot one in Clemson, and the Charlotte fans smart enough to be under the shade. No score between Bisons and the 49ers. Here's some headlines from yesterday. Nick LaRusso had a solo home run from Maryland to reach the century mark in RBI. Dylan Campbell, 36-game hit streak, had one against Louisiana yesterday.
And a highlight reel catch, too, in right field. I think it was SportsCenter. Number two on the top 10. Three number ones lose. Coastal, who's off to a quick start today. They're up 4-0. Oklahoma State and Auburn. The SEC 9-1. The only SEC team to lose was Auburn.
Big Ten undefeated. They won. Here's David Coppedge. The Camels of Campbell lost their opener yesterday. Top scoring offense in the country. Not have a good day. Now they're trailing Central Connecticut State 2-0 in the third.
It's a day after South Carolina put 19 on that same club.
Coppedge 1-for-5 with a run batted in yesterday. 19, huh? Does that change how you feel about South Carolina going forward?
Not quite yet. No.
Coppedge, former Virginia Cavalier, they won again. They've now got a, 26-game non-conference win streak? I think they're 26-0.
That would be a 26-game streak.
Mm-hmm. Coppedge made his seventh consecutive start at second base last night. He started the first seven games of the season and then worked his way around, and he goes down swinging on a breaking ball. That's strikeout number 6 for Hudepohl.
Not a whole lot of hangover effect from the conference tournament so far from Hudepohl. Fastball's been up to 94, but this has been the key. That curveball has been special today. He's thrown a few of those at 87 miles an hour, too. The good ones have been kind of 84, 85, but has landed it when he's needed to and then expanded it when he gets in a plus count.
Here's a 9-hole hitter, Will Lee. Switch hitter from Spring, Texas. 0-for-4 yesterday. Hudepohl's fastball is hit to right field, and there's the second hit of the game. And turn the lineup over for Caleb Ketchup. Grounded out to first, his first time up.
This is where Lipscomb can do some damage. Ketchup, 17 home runs, 31 bags this year. Vergara on deck, 23 home runs, 5 in his last two games.
Yeah. Ketchup's a sophomore from Atlanta, started his college career at Georgia. And he has been the leadoff hitter for the Bisons this year, every game in the leadoff spot, every game at short. He didn't like that call from Bill McGuire and asked for clarification.
Man, that one may have been a little bit down.
Ketchup 5'10", 160. Was also a football player in high school. In addition to his athletic exploits, plays the viola.
I don't hear that one every day.
No. Nope. Unless you're listening to the Viola channel on Sirius XM.
Fair point.
Slightly larger than a violin, has a lower and deeper sound. For those curious, I know I was. Cello to right. Now, 1 foot of catch made by Fisher, two down. Here's Vergara. How about the home runs this dude hit yesterday?
First one cleared everything. 155 feet. It's 111 off the bat. Second one just snuck about 40 feet over the wall.
Feels like Gorilla Ball is back.
Numbers would say so. On pace to break the all-time home run record.
Kind of a throwback, not quite a Black Magic, but close.
Yeah, it's got the same paint scheme. They brought that back, and they brought the old gray and green, which used to be the only two Eastons you could buy. That was it. Which one do you want?
Nothing in two.
Those are back to like the Robin Ventura, Pete Incaviglia, Brad Bean Blossom, Monty Ferris days.
Never forget Brad Bean Blossom. How many did he hit?
He hit a bunch. They all did that year.
Just off the plate.
Just off, just down, but a really good spot and a really good take right there, too, by Vergara, because that's exactly where Hudepohl wanted to throw. Spot that he can't do anything with. Close enough that maybe you can get it to offer. The hand started, but barrel didn't follow.
Hudepohl has struck out six, and this ball is torched to left. It'll get down and get all the way to the fence. Headed to third is Lee, and they'll stop him there. Another extra base hit for Alex Vergara. Two out double.
It's a really good at bat by Vergara, because ultimately he took the breaking ball he couldn't do anything with. Then he got another one, and this catch is enough of the plate. Lucky he didn't get underneath this one if you're Charlotte, because it goes a long way. Blake Jackson played this perfectly out in left field.
Did he?
Took it on one hop, barehanded, spins around. If that rolls around at all, Jeff Forehand's going to send the runner for sure. But Jackson played it perfectly, hit the cutoff man. That one only 109 off the bat right there.
By the way, not as easy as it seems here with no warning track and just the rise to the outfield wall. That carom came right back to Jackson. Here's Mason Lundgren. Two outs, and Hudepohl delivers a fastball for a strike. Bill Wilhelm didn't like the look of the cinder track, so he said, let's keep it all green all the way to the wall. Hudepohl's got something in his eye. Needs time. Well, that can't be comfortable as a pitcher.
What's that?
Getting a bug in your eye.
It's not comfortable for anybody. It's not just limited to pitchers.
Well hit left field, Jackson chasing, that gets down, Lipscomb gets two home, gets under Jackson's glove. And Mason Lundgren puts Lipscomb up 2-0 in the third.
Here's that offense starting to come alive. It was a two-out double by Vergara that put two in scoring position. Then Mason Lundgren comes up. I think he got a high breaking ball right there. That one just stayed up. Stays on it, shoots it out to left field. Lipscomb is first on the board with two here in the second with two outs.
Lundgren had been 0 for 5 with 4 Ks this week prior to that big hit. And a fastball misses to Trace Wilhoit, 1-0.
Brad Beanblossom hit 10 in 1989, by the way.
Incavelia hit nearly 5 times as many, and you put him in the same conversation.
Because it's an awesome name. I mean, it'll always get in that conversation.
One and two. J.J. Weatherholt has homered for West Virginia. They're now up on Ball State 3-1 early on. The Charlotte team that may be the most aggressive we've seen among the four with their infield alignments.
They had the 6-4-3 charts in the dugout before this one with all the different defensive looks that they'll give based on the hitter and sometimes based on stuff on the mound, too.
Popped up out of play. Yeah, one of the members of the coaching staff was posted up at the Starbucks yesterday morning, had everything spread out, going over the spray charts. And Robert Woodard was on a North Carolina staff that was probably ahead of the curve. They had a student assistant who ran all their analytics and their World Series run a couple years ago.
Yeah, he was at the front of that. He was, I would say, one of the first from a pitching coach standpoint to really utilize analytics to the level that we see many others doing it right now.
It only made sense that the numbers would trickle down to the college game. The trends would. It's just that you needed somebody like the company we use, 6-4-3, to compile all the information. Beautiful approaching 60 pitches. Nolan backing up. And on the dirt, hauls it in for the third out. But a couple of runs on 3 hits, including back-to-back doubles from Vergara and Lundgren, and Lipscomb leads.
Subway just keeps getting better. Break it down, Candace.
They got world-class bakers to develop their tastiest bread yet. This truly makes the Subway Series a dream team. You know about that, Chuck.
Yeah, I was the bread of that team, too.
Try the Subway Series menu. Their tastiest refresh yet.
The Subway Series is getting an upgrade. The new number 19, the Pickleball Club. Who knew the Subway Series could get even better?
Me. I knew.
Maybe you should host a commercial then.
Sure, okay. Subway Series just keeps getting better.
With MultiView on YouTube TV, you can watch 4 games at once. It's perfect for people who love watching the game, and the game, and the game, and the game. YouTube TV, it's more than cable for $600 less than cable. Try it for free.
To you, it may just be an elevator.
Here goes nothing.
But for a young homeowner becoming their parents, it's a learning opportunity.
Come on in. The more the merrier.
Paris, huh?
Bonjour.
We got any out-of-towners in the elevator?
Tom, it is not easy.
10th floor, huh? Must be a heck of a view.
Okay, so you're offering what else is facing this way?
Progressive can't save you from becoming your parents, but we can save you money when you buy a home and auto with us.
Okay, that was terrible. Okay, let's hang back. We're going to try that again.
Oh, so
gentle.
Yeah!
I'm thinking about an NIL deal with Potbelly Deli.
It's good placement right there.
Caden Grice will be on the mound game tonight against Tennessee.
He likes this place. He stayed around and watched the game last night. The yard early today. Solid uni again.
Uh-huh. Don't forget your sunscreen. Might be a long day. I feel like a sun nap coming on for some of these little ones. Here's Spencer Nolan, beach boy from Wilmington, North Carolina. First AB. Two home runs. He's driven in 14. Spencer's brother, Parker, played at North Carolina State, is playing at North Carolina State. Transferred from Davidson. What NC State do yesterday?
They won. They will play South Carolina tonight. And they beat Campbell.
Fourth inning in Gainesville, Florida A&M leads UConn 2-1. Straight back. What was the most surprising loss in your mind yesterday?
Probably Coastal. I mean, Oral Roberts is 3-0 against Oklahoma State this year, so I don't know that that could be looked at as a giant surprise. Penn's been on a heater. I think they came in at 110 in a row. But Ryder beating Coastal the way that they did and the diving play to end it, I think that'd be it. Brayden Tucker's on a heater himself today. That's four strikeout, two in the first, one in the second, now one in the third to get the first out. He's now gone through the Charlotte lineup, giving up just two singles.
Here's Blake Jackson. What's your nickname for Terre Haute?
Paradise.
Paradise.
Little Indiana State, Iowa in the winner's bracket game there.
What a big win for Iowa, taking down North Carolina. With the Tar Heels threatening in the ninth inning last night.
And Indiana State needed three in the eighth to win their opener.
Chopped it foul, 2-1.
Hey, I got something for you.
All right.
There's a rain delay in Coral Gables right now. The Maine Black Bears and the Raging Cajuns are watching it pour right now.
Probably not raining in Orono. Maine should have hosted.
They used to.
Two and two. Breaking ball low and in. Perhaps the most famous black bear will be in the building tonight. Jack Leggett.
Yeah. Watched them play in Omaha years ago.
Did you buy a hat?
Darn right I did.
Fastball up and in. Ball four to Jackson.
Yeah, that was the gig. I mean, you had to pick a team every year. Go get the hat. Maine 1 year, Citadel the year that they made it.
Leggett had his number 7 retired this year. Back part of the program, hanging out with Eric Bakich in the Clemson dugout. Was Creighton in Omaha? I mean, Creighton is in Omaha, but did Creighton make it to the College World Series 91-ish?
It was 90 or 91.
Yeah. That was the year I bought a Creighton hat.
Really?
Yeah.
Brian O'Connor thanks you.
Oh, right back up the middle, and it sneaks through. Got past a couple of Bisons. First past Tucker's hip, and then Coppedge, who was racing to cover the bag, couldn't adjust, and Dragom's got a knock to put runners at first and third.
This could have gone both ways, really good or really bad for Charlotte. So put the hit and run on. Blake Jackson's moving. Dragom does exactly what you're trying to do, just hit it on the ground hard somewhere. We just about hit Coppedge in stride. If he fields that, he's got a chance to turn two. Instead, Blake Jackson goes first to third. About halfway home on that one. Now Charlotte's got something cooking here, two on, one out.
And the nation's home run leader, Cam Fisher. Started him with a pair of fastballs last time. This time goes with a breaking ball, nothing and one.
In Team 91, Creighton was, in fact, in the College World Series, and they won their opening game against Clemson.
Maybe that's why I bought the hat. And a line drive that's pulled foul. White hat, blue bill, blue sea.
I think they still got him. Jim Henry was the head coach.
If I ever get back to Omaha, I'll buy another one. Breaking ball for strike three. Fisher is the fifth strikeout victim of the game for Tucker, and that was the biggest K so far.
We talked about 23 of 30 home runs this year on the fastball, and he was hunting fastball right here. He wasn't looking for this. Watch the reaction. Looking for a fastball that he can lean on and just gives up on that breaking ball that really ended up right down the middle of the plate. That's a giant strikeout for Braden Tucker. Now five in the game, but strikes out one of the most dangerous hitters in the country right there with two on.
And now Jack Cunningham. Cunningham struck out to end the first. Cunningham's a Charlotte native, played his high school ball at Audrey Kell High School. Two and oh. And for a strike.
Tough one there. That one's off the plate. You can see the reaction of Cunningham just kind of looking back at Bill McGuire like, I don't agree with you right there. And in this case, Cunningham was right.
The 2-2. Swing and a miss. Six strikeouts for Tucker. And he works his way around two on with only one out. Back-to-back strikeouts of Fisher and Cunningham. Lipscomb leads 2-0.
YouTube TV is more than cable for less than cable. And who doesn't like more? Just ask anyone who loves basketball. And they'll tell you, there's no such thing as too much of it. Watch more games at once with MultiView on YouTube TV. YouTube TV, it's more than cable for $600 less than cable. Try it for free.
I'm gonna pull over and stretch my legs.
I think he was supposed to keep left there.
Hmm? What is this place?
The other side of the rest stop.
Bundles as far as the eye can see.
If you're looking for a first mate, I know a guy. Me, I'm the guy.
Is this oak?
Four types of jerky. This is where I live now.
You could save a ton with Progressive by bundling your boat or RV with your home and auto.
Hey, guys! Free bags! They're just giving them away!
This right here is the extra-large New York-style pizza from Papa John's. And in order to make a big, tasty, extra-large New York-style pizza like this, you gotta really hand-stretch that fresh, never-frozen dough made from only six simple ingredients. like this. Woof! Look at that. That's what makes a Papa John's Extra Large New York Style Pizza Papa John's. Better ingredients, better pizza, but you knew that.
This is Squeeze Play, where we bring you the best moments of all around college baseball.
We go up on Taco! 3-1 Johnson. Oh! Goodness gracious.
Let's go.
Let's get quadratic.
What more do you want? Are you not entertained?
Yeah, and by the way, nobody wants to go home. Just play it out, run it back, let's go.
We head to the fourth inning. Austin Kelly leads off for Lipscomb. He is 0 for 1 with a strikeout. Scan that QR code. You can see Mike Rooney wear a bucket hat and Chris Burke break down the 10th Congressional District. Low and in. 2-0. Quite a contrast last night, even though they had the same uni on.
They did. Yeah. No, they shopped in the same aisle, but Berkey didn't have three different bucket hats, I know that.
2-0 to Kelly. A missed opportunity for Charlotte in the third inning. Got Cam Fisher looking at a slider, and then Jake Cunningham struck out. That's the heart of the order for the 49ers, and now White Hudepohl issues a four-pitch walk to Kelly to start the fourth.
I would bet that Charlotte bullpen starts going pretty quick because the concern with Hudepohl, you can pitch on adrenaline for a while, but it's hard to pitch on adrenaline for six or seven innings. And early, I think it was adrenaline. Punched out two in the first, punched out three in the second. Now the game gets a little more real. It gives up two in the last on three hits, and now walks Austin Kelly on four that really weren't all that close.
It is 86 and hot out here.
Michael O was the pitching coach who was wearing that uniform and actually on the mound here the last few years, but he's moved into that role. Robert Woodard's background more on the pitching side, but O has been handling some of that this year. Quick discussion right there with Hudepohl.
NCAA Regionals coverage for all 16 sites continues tomorrow on ESPN Plus and the ESPN app. For more information, visit NCAA.com, the home for all 90 NCAA championships.
Those guys were actually teammates last year.
Hudepohl and O.
Yeah. O was a pitcher on this staff last year, and I was moved into that role.
Low and in to Jake Berg. Berg struck out looking in the second. One on one. They're getting some action up. Donya Evans, Vanderbilt transfer, getting loose. Almost got away from Nolan. I don't know if I've ever seen numbers like this for Austin Kelly in the run game. He is perfect on the base paths, 13 for 13. And opponents are perfect against him. 28 for 28.
No, I've never seen numbers like that.
Confusion, Charlotte, defensive alignment. And the pitch misses up. They got the shortstop, Dragom, moving towards the bag. And Stallman was a little hesitant on where he was going.
They were waiting until there was two strikes, and then they held Dragom just on the shortstop side of second base.
2-2. Off the plate, full count. Huda pulls pitch, runner on the move, and a line drive down the right side. That is foul.
Close. Kelly off and moving on that. You would think he's probably off and moving again. 3-2 count. You're trusting that Burke can put it in play, and he just about hooked one down the right field line for a double right there. Top of the fifth, two out. Central Connecticut leads Campbell 3-0. Highest scoring offense in the country, scored one yesterday, and they're getting shut out today.
They've only been held to two runs or fewer in back-to-back games one time over the last 3 years. Picked up at first base, a step there, need a tag at second, and a 3-6 double play turned by Spencer Nolan. That'll help Huda pull.
Nolan holding that runner on, so he's coming off a step, and then it turns into a pretty easy play. It's just one step, step on the bag, make sure that you can get that to drag him just in enough time to get the tag down. He does, not even a slide right there, so the leadoff walk is erased. The 3-6 double play.
Here's Parks Bauk. He was a strikeout victim his first time up. Chop to the second baseman on the left side of the bag, and a long 4-3 ground out. Leadoff walk did no damage. 43rd double play of the season turned by Charlotte. And now they need some offense.
To them, the whole world looks like an opportunity, one to be seized, built upon, and made better for their sport and the people around it. To student athletes, every opportunity is a chance to change what could be and show the world what opportunity can do.
Hey, and one more.
No, I think we got it.
Yeah, let's focus on the RV. Come on.
RV?
Okay, everybody, look at the RV and smile.
This is what you want for your family portrait.
Good point. We bundled the boat with our home and auto first. Hey, team, get on in here.
Team? Oh, fun.
Now everyone say 24/7 financial protection with Progressive.
24/7 financial protection with Progressive.
Okay.
Let's get some singles and me on the bike.
Honey?
Yeah. This is Roundup for lawns. This stuff works. This stuff kills weeds down to the root without killing your lawn. This stuff works on dandelions, crabgrass, clover. This stuff works for up to 3 months. This stuff works guaranteed or your money back. This stuff works on big lawns, small lawns, and I guess you can call that a lawns. This stuff works without killing your lawn. This stuff works without killing your weekend. This stuff works for the rookies and the seasoned pros. This stuff works in Knoxville, Bronxville, Rockville, Marysville. This is Roundup for lawns. This stuff works.
Welcome back to the NCAA Baseball Regionals presented by Capital One. Winner of this bracket gets Auburn in the Supers, the Auburn winner of the Auburn Regional. And whoever wins tonight will have a huge advantage. 81% of regional winners start 2-0. 6 o'clock Eastern on ESPN2. The Esso Club.
Just saw that.
Darkened the door there last night. What'd you think, your first experience?
Impressive. My kind of joint. To get there a little earlier tonight, get a little bit more food.
Mm-hmm. Brandon Stallman with a grounder to the right side. One down. Here's Austin Knight. A little extra rest for Clemson, right? I mean, they played the early game yesterday. Tennessee won the night game. It was over by 9 o'clock. Here's Knight with a swing and a miss. Nothing at two.
They're having a really hard time with this slot. It looked like it was a slider that just kind of stays there. But Charlotte is not picking the ball up out of Tucker's hand. The fastball's been 90-91. There's been a fair amount of swing and miss.
Tucker struck out six. He's walked one. Make it seven strikeouts. Well, he just looks pretty comfortable out there, huh?
Yeah, I think that's a right on right changeup. Didn't throw it a whole lot this year, but 86 miles an hour. I mean, it was right down the heart of the plate, and I just couldn't pull the trigger on it.
Bill McGuire stepped out behind home plate and was motioning either to Caleb Ketchup or to Michael Banks, the second base umpire. Oh, we're told he just had to move the rosin bag behind the mound. Okay, that makes sense. Ketchup was saying that they're like, what, you talking to me?
I didn't do anything.
Him, me, him, me.
Is there a National Ketchup Day? There's a reason for this question.
We can do a modicum of research. That's all we're expected.
I will never forget when Joey Pancake from South Carolina hit two home runs on National Pancake Day. And it was one of the, I think, the favorite things that Mike Patrick ever saw in his broadcasting career.
We're 2 days away from
National Ketchup Day. There's a chance. There is a chance. Lipscomb's got to get on a heater, but could repeat itself.
Joey Pancake,
South Carolina.
Yeah.
Did two home runs on National Pancake Day, and Mike Patrick just about lost it.
Mike Patrick called some huge events during his career and saw some major moments in American sports television, but that may have been the biggest.
It was up there. Sunday Night Football.
Big bowl games.
Nope.
How do you think Joey celebrated?
There's only one way. Go get some waffles.
That's insult. The Stack family. Here's the 1-2 to Hobson. Fastball missed up and away.
It's not every day that you get a battle with National Gingerbread Day, and that's what Monday is also.
Mm.
Ooh, got him.
One walk, one hit batter against seven strikeouts for Braden Tucker. And that'll bring Will Butcher up. National Butchers Week is in March. Don't know about bakers or candlestick makers. Don't have any of those in this game.
Top it off Monday because it's also National Moonshine Day. Roll them all together and you got a wonderful afternoon.
Look at that moonshine. Full moon last night. Is that why everything got weird late? Butcher popped up to first base his last time up. If fights that one off. He's from just up the road in Arden, North Carolina, T.C. Roberson High School. Started his college career at NC State. This is a Charlotte team that 2 years ago in the tournament knocked off Maryland in the regional. He had three hits in that game and hit 500 for the weekend. Butcher helped T.C. Roberson to a state championship in 2017. And that year, he led the entire state of North Carolina in RBI. Got it in foul territory, and that one will be chased by Hobson. A couple of pretty good players out of T.C. Roberson High School, including Cameron Mabin.
Yeah, that'd qualify.
And a basketball guy by the name of Roy Williams. Line drive to left. And a base hit for Butcher. Two on with two out. Bottom of the order doing some damage here for Charlotte.
That was a quiet start to the inning. Ground ball in the infield, a strikeout. Caden Hobson's hit on the back foot. Butcher fires one to left. Now up to Spencer Nolan to keep this one going. Really. And they're more for his defense. He's been a great defensive first baseman. We've already seen that today. They could use one right here. Turn this lineup over and see if Charlotte can get on the board. It won't be Parker Nolan. Eli Wiesner steps to the plate. Got a pinch hitter for Charlotte here in the fourth.
Won't be Parker Nolan. Won't be Spencer Nolan.
That dropped Parker off.
That's fine. We saw Wiesner pinch hit last night in the seventh inning. Parker Nolan and Vanderbilt won yesterday. Parker also plays first base, so easily confused. Three home runs, 10 ribbies for Wiesner. And he pulled a foul. Two and two.
Good take, good pitch. Tucker trying to run that slider in that exact same spot, just off the plate. Wiesner fresh off the bench. That's a good one to hold off of.
Time called, and Trace Wilhoit's going to head to the mound. You think it's something that Wilhoit saw?
I don't know if it was a verbal or maybe if you saw movement. One of the base runners thinking somebody's got signs. Yeah, that's a. You don't see that conference very often, especially with a 2-2 count, two outs.
Big moment in this game with two on and two out in the bottom of the order. Pitch from Tucker.
The other thing it could have been, there's no visible pitch clock here. The third base umpire keeps the pitch clock. Mm-hmm. If maybe it was getting tight, he may have mentioned something to Will Hoyt just to remind Tucker that you got to work within that 20-second frame.
Angel Campos has the clock. Fly ball, right field, racing back is Lee, all the way to the fence, it's gone! Three-run home run, pinch hit Jack for Wiesner, and Charlotte's got the lead.
Pretty good time for Robert Woodard to put the home run sign on right there, because you go pinch hitter and Wiesner, who's below 200 on the year but can do this, can run one out of the ballpark, especially on a day like this. This ball wouldn't even hit great. I mean, he definitely did not get all of it, but he got just enough. Off the bat, it looked like Will Lee had a beat on it right. He did not carry just far enough. Three runs on one swing, and the 49ers have their first lead of the day.
Back to the top of the order. Now Braden Tucker's got to bounce back. Fourth home run of the season for Wiesner. Two and oh. Rio to Blake Jackson on the way. Down in Conway, Coastal got a first inning grand slam, and now the Shawnts lead UNCW 6-0 in the fifth. Full count.
A grand slam and a two-run home run. That's all the offense there. UConn is come back to take the lead on Florida A&M. North Carolina 1-0 top of the sixth against Wright State.
Ground ball to the left side. Ketchup sprawls out. He's able to stop it, but has no play. And Blake Jackson's reached base safely all three times he's come to the plate.
Inning started pretty good if you're Lipscomb. Got two outs, nobody on. Hit by pitch, single ball in the seats. Now backside ground ball from Blake Jackson. Beats the shift. Ketchup lays out. Good play just to glove it, but not enough time to get on his feet. Matt Myers will make his way to the mound right now. First discussion he's had today with Braden Tucker.
Tucker needed just five pitches to retire the first two batters. 26 thrown to the next four. Myers pitched in this ballpark, played for Rod Demonico in Tennessee in the late 90s. Now the pitching coach for Lipscomb. Second season, he's had 19 MLB draftees came to Lipscomb from UNCW. Joey Mitchell just started throwing in the Bison's bullpen. As it start getting loose, I should say. Two-hole hitter, Jack Dragum. And Dragum sends this one deep to center field. And that one is gone! Two-run home run for Dragum. Park's not going to hold much today. Trogum's 11th.
Taking advantage of your surroundings right here. Eli Wiesner rides the win out to right center. That was a three-run shot. This one 103 off the bat. And I think off the bat, Dragon thought this had a chance, but it definitely wasn't a no-doubter. Just kept flying out to center field. Alex Vergara runs out of room. That's now 5 2-out runs in the inning for Charlotte.
390 feet to center field. That one measured by Trackman is 392-foot shot. Here's Cam Fisher. Now 10 home runs hit in this regional here at Doug Kinsmore Stadium. Say went, nothing at two. This run for Charlotte started with a two-out, two-strike hit by pitch that put Caden Hobson aboard. Time, oh, man. McGuire gave him time and was walking the opposite direction of the batter as the umpire does. And Tucker let that one go just over his head. What goes through a pitcher's mind when you're midway through your delivery and hear time?
I always wanted to throw it. I didn't,
like right down the middle?
Yeah, just throw it. I mean, even to do that, just throw it to the backstop, but throw it. Stopping just never felt. Every once in a while, too, if it's so late, if you stop, you can hurt yourself.
Fisher goes down on the fastball. But before that, Charlotte puts together a five-run inning thanks to a couple of big home runs from Wiesner and Dragon. We'll ask Robert Woodard about it after this.
I like to move it, you like to move it.
We're reinventing our network.
Move it. I like to move it, I like to move it, I like to move it, you like to move it. I like to move it, you like to move it.
Fast, reliable, perfectly orchestrated. The United States Postal Service.
With MultiView on YouTube TV, you can watch four games at once. It's perfect for people who love watching the game, and the game, and the game, and the game. YouTube TV, it's more than cable for $600 less than cable. Try it for free.
Is that KFC chicken sandwich spicy?
Sinfully.
I'd do anything for one.
Anything.
Gotcha one.
Order any KFC sandwich online till July 2nd for Diablo 4 reward.
Tom Hart, Kyle Peterson, joined by Charlotte head coach Robert Woodard. Hey, let's rewind that fourth inning with two outs, two strikes. Caden Hobson gets hit by a pitch. Butcher comes up with a base hit. What drove the decision to send Eli Wiesner up as a pinch hitter?
Well, I mean, you know, chasing two runs in the fourth, it's, you know, we changed the game plan. You got to go more offensive. We're not going to, you know, Spencer Nolan, you saw his defensive play that he made there at first base, and that's a huge reason why he's in there. But, you know, at this point, it's about scoring runs, and Eli, what a great swing of the bat he put on that ball.
Yeah, it changed the game for sure. We talked about who to pull before this game, and you had a concern of, all right, is there carryover because he pitched a fair amount last weekend. What have you seen from him so far? Because he was really good early.
Yeah, he's a warrior, and he's never out of the fight until we go get him. So he's just giving it all he's got and laying on the line, and that's what you guys are seeing today.
Coach, thanks for your time. We appreciate it.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. It's an eight to the plate. They get five runs on four hits. Home runs from Wiesner and Dragon. And David Coppedge at the plate for the Bisons. So Wiesner, he stays in the game at first base. In for a strike to Coppedge.
They get that extra adrenaline rush right here. Hudepohl goes out there. He's down 2-0 the last time he was on the mound. You step back out there with a three-run lead. Sometimes the stuff gets a little bit sharper again.
Hey. full count. And strike three on Coppedge. Seventh strikeout for Huitipel.
Yeah, he had really leaned on the breaking ball for a lot of this game, and this is one of the best fastballs he threw. Maybe not velocity-wise. It was 93 miles an hour. He's shown 94, but location was perfect. Two-seamer bottom of the zone, right on the inside part of the plate. Coppedge just couldn't pull the trigger.
Will Lee coming up. I think Charlotte repositions its infield more than any team I've ever seen.
They don't play you straight up very much, that's for sure. And it's different levels of shift. See if they do anything else with two strikes. A lot of times, yeah, in this case, you take Stallman to third baseman and play it almost a shallow shortstop position.
The 0-2. Lipscomb had a 2-0 lead going into the bottom of the fourth with two outs. Back-to-back K's. Now 8 for Huitipel.
There's the split. Seen it too much today, but been pretty breaking ball heavy. Wanted to go off speed. That one's got enough tumble that it starts on the plate and just kind of keeps falling.
So just 2 days away from National Ketchup Day, Caleb Ketchup comes to the plate. Hit a home run yesterday. Ketchup last year, freshman All-American, A-Sun Defensive Player of the Year. And named to the A-Sun freshman team. They have the strike. Nothing at two. That's the second time Ketchup has seen one low called a strike against.
It's been a strike all day, though. I mean, it looks like it's a little down and out of the zone, but it has consistently been called a strike.
And strike three. Huitipel K's the side. We'll talk with Jeff Forehand, who is talking with the home plate umpire, Bill McGuire. We'll catch up with him in a moment.
Break free from overpriced wireless with Boost Mobile. Switch to Boost and get a free Samsung Galaxy A23 5G phone with the power of America's largest 5G networks. Switch to Boost and get a free Samsung Galaxy A23 phone. Boost Mobile. Unleash your power.
I like to move it, you like to
move it.
We're reinventing our network. Fast, reliable, perfectly orchestrated. The United States Postal Service.
Is that KFC chicken sandwich spicy?
Sinfully.
I'd do anything for one.
Anything. Gotcha one.
Order any KFC sandwich online till July 2nd for Diablo 4 reward.
Here's our Sunday night baseball matchup, one of the great old school rivalries in MLB history. It's a series finale between the Yankees and the Dodgers. Game starts at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific on ESPN, ESPN Deportes, and ESPN Radio. Our coverage begins at 6 Eastern, 3 Pacific with Baseball Tonight Sunday Night Countdown. Josh Donaldson and Giancarlo Stanton returned to action last night for the Yankees. Neither one of them have played since at least mid-April. There's a discussion at the end of that half inning between Bill McGuire and Jeff Forehand, Lipscomb's head coach. And it seemed to have started when McGuire wanted to talk to Forehand with a warning, maybe too strong a word, but perhaps Caleb Ketchup shared his opinion about the strike zone. And the more McGuire talked to Forehand, the more Forehand got irritated.
Got a little more heated. I think it's understandable.
Seemed like he called him over and said, hey, listen, your guy probably needs to keep his opinion to himself. And maybe Forehand said, well, maybe your strike zone needs to be better. Called it a foul ball. And Jake Cunningham will stay in there.
Yeah, Jake Cunningham reacts differently. He may get away with this one. We saw this last night. Sound is kind of the one thing you have to go off. It hit it was behind his hands. It didn't even hit the knob.
Cunningham has struck out twice, so he chops this one off the plate. Will Hoyt's do or die play, and he can't make one. And a little funky side spin on it, and Jake Cunningham with an infield single.
I would think if he went to Robert Woodard before the game and said Cam Fisher and Jake Cunningham are going to strike out their first five times today, I don't know if you'd think he'd have the lead, but that's exactly what happened. Now Cunningham comes up right here and just gets it in the right spot for Will Hoyt. You got to guess, but that spin takes it away from that bare hand, even if he fields it cleanly. I don't think he gets Cunningham. It's a leadoff single here in the fifth.
Brandon Stallman is 0 for 2 tonight. Up the middle, chance for two. Ketchup will kick the bag and sidearm it over. That'll help the mood on that side.
About 5 or 6 years ago, this is a single right back up the middle. But all the spray charts that are out there right now, Lipscomb had him defended perfectly. Ketchup up the middle, took it, had plenty of time, stepped on almost too much time. Short hopped it over to Lundgren and picked him up.
Austin Knight to Ketchup. And Ketchup will tie a record. Six pitch inning worked by Braden Tucker. 5-2 Charlotte through five.
I like to move it, move it. You like to
move it.
We're reinventing our network.
Move it. I like to move it, move it.
Reliable, perfectly orchestrated. The United States Postal Service.
And we're done.
Huh. What about these?
Looks right.
The quicker picker-upper. When you gotta get it done, one sheet is all you need. And Bounty is 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less and get the job done with one.
This works.
Kinda.
Bounty, the quicker picker-upper.
5-2 Charlotte leads. We're in the sixth inning. First game of the day, it's an elimination game between the 49ers and the Bisons. And we got Clemson and Tennessee tonight. Gonna be a hot one today.
Multiple uses for a spoon.
Uh-huh. College baseball is rad. Where do you get that?
Big donkey hat. I love it. College baseball's rad. Steven Shocks, I got five of those sitting at home right now. Actually, I was going to bring you one, but I forgot. So never mind.
Good intentions. That's how I feel. Why, Huitipel is 86 pitches into his day.
So they always drag. They always drag after the fifth, right? Right. We used to do the exact same thing, but we had to do it. It was all the pitchers that weren't pitching.
Mm-hmm.
So it was rally drags. You go get the drags and hold them up the entire inning. Rarely worked.
But you walked. Nobody got on a tractor.
No, old school walk. Pull it right behind you. There was five of us. You did one loop and you were done.
Did you stop and do the YMCA or anything halfway through?
No, we weren't that advanced, and if we would have, we probably would have been dismissed from the team.
Alex Vergara hit a couple of home runs yesterday. He's got a double today. You don't think Mark Marquess would appreciate the YMCA in the midst of a game?
No. If we were winning, then we may not get kicked out. If we were losing, we would have run till we puked.
Well, that doesn't take as long anymore. Against the shift, it sneaks under the glove of Austin Knight, and Vergara with a perfectly placed ground ball. He's now 5-for-8 in two games. And that'll bring Mason Lundgren up. Squeeze play on ESPN Plus right now is quadratic.
Let's get quadratic. I think Randy Hood from UNC Wilmington was just asked to leave himself. The head coach was like, his day is done. UNC Wilmington's run is about done.
Third baseman playing in, and a first pitch to Lundgren is a strike. ...90 pitches so far for Huitipel.
He'd been really good. And it looked like the stuff was tilting down a little bit in the third inning. This is a big spot because he's got to get through this middle of the lineup. I don't think he's going to face this part of the lineup again, so it's probably his last turn through the guys that can do a lot of damage. Lundgren, not a lot of power. But then you got Will Hoyt to follow with 17 and Kelly to follow with 21 home runs.
Lundgren drove in a pair with a double in the third. UConn of FAMU tied at 5 in the sixth. Spicy in Gainesville. Chance for a double play. Shuffled to short, and that's all they'll get. Just didn't move fast enough.
Yeah, I think just not hit hard enough. That was 45 miles an hour off the bat, so it's going to take a little bit of time to get out towards second base. But Austin Knight with a good job. Flips it over to Dragon. Make sure they get that lead runner. Now you're still ground ball away from getting out of it. And yet again, Charlotte shifts, and this is a true shift. They got three infielders on shortstop side of second base.
Here's Trace Wilhoit. He is 1-for-2.
I mean, it's not easy as a hitter just to say, okay, hit a ground ball to the right side of the infield, but if you're Lipscomb right now, you just need base runners.
Mm-hmm.
And if you just hit a ground ball to the right side of the infield, you got a really good chance of standing on first base.
In the air to the right side, and this will end up into the stands. Not much of an effort by that Charlotte fan.
Hmm.
One ball, one strike to Trace Wilhoit. 66 strikeouts in the season for Wilhoit. Two and one. Into left field, a little top spin, and that will die in the glove of Blake Jackson. Two down. And Austin Kelly coming up. Campbell still hadn't scored a run.
That is, I think that may be the most shocking thing so far for me. I thought Campbell was maybe going to go on a run through this regional. They had a really good draw. NC State was probably the last team into the field. I mean, can beat anybody. They played in the ACC, but still. And then South Carolina came in a little bit banged up. Campbell's in danger of getting eliminated. Two and Q and scoring a run.
College baseball is a long season. And I'm sure mentally that's a Campbell team that's dealing with question marks of the future and the disappointment that they didn't host when they had a beat on it late in the year.
Their head coach, Justin Hare, is going to be mentioned for a lot of names, and rightfully so. It's been a very consistent run since he has been at Campbell.
Kelly pounds it to the right side and smothered by Knight. Threw it away at first, but no one's able to advance. Two on with two out.
Now, this is the difference. We talked about Spencer Nolan earlier and how good he is defensively over there. And Austin Knight kind of gave up on this. I think he thought Wiestner was going to make the play. Goes backhand, can't do it, and then Knight has to pick up the speed a little bit.
That was a heck of an effort.
Yeah. Oh, the throw from the backside, it's the only chance you got. Just sailed a little bit wide. It should go as an infield single. Lipscomb's got something going here, though. Two on, two out for Jake Berg, who's got three home runs this year.
They charged Wiestner with an error on that play.
That's incorrect.
Well, I don't. Factual statement. Here's Jake Berg. Went under his glove, you think.
What do you got, Greg Campbell? Partial official score. I get the
Got the shoulder shrug. Berg hit into a double play his last time up. 1-1. Hunter one pitches now for Hudepohl.
I would think this is probably his last. Danielle Evans up and thrown in a Charlotte bullpen, who was up earlier in this game. Did not pitch yesterday for Charlotte. Did warm up, but didn't come into the game.
Here's the 1-2. To the right side again. Wiestner with the toss, and Hudepohl get to the bag. 103 pitches for Wyatt Hudepohl, and he is the pitcher of record. Middle of the sixth. 5-2 Charlotte.
I like to move it, you like to
move it.
We're reinventing our network.
Move it. I like to move it, I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to
move it.
Fast, reliable, perfectly orchestrated. The United States Postal Service.
Sometimes we lose, sometimes we win. Sometimes we try to fit it all in. Sometimes we don't know what's in store. Sometimes we find what we're looking for. Sometimes we're rolling easy and free. Sometimes one and one makes three. So much to love along this ride. That's why Nationwide is on your side.
Hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is that punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is every single time you take a bite, you know you're gonna get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. The Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches. There's no touching it.
Joined by Lipscomb head coach Jeff Forehand here in the sixth inning. Coach, thanks for joining us. We've been just amazed with Alex Vergara's power that we've seen. That home run he hit yesterday maybe still hadn't come down. What role has the long ball played for your team as a whole over the season?
A little different this year than normal years, but we've hit a few more this year than I think we have since I've been there. So again, long ball has been good for us, but still got a lot of other things that we can do a little bit better. But for sure, Alex has swung the bat really well.
Hey, Jeff, Braden Tucker's been really good today. I mean, two outs, nobody on in the fourth, and then obviously, he had a rough five or six hitters after that. But what have you seen from your side?
Man, just great. I mean, we just over here talking about it. I mean, he's doing great. Made two bad pitches, but we were in that inning with five pitches and two outs, yeah. And then nobody on, and then it kind of erupted on a two-strike hit by pitch. So, you just got to keep giving him the ball. He's been doing it all year long, so hopefully he can keep us in it.
Coach, thanks for your time. We appreciate it.
Thanks, guys.
Let's go ahead, Coach Jeff Forehand, back-to-back years, A-Sun Coach of the Year, 17th season at the helm. Caden Hobson leads off the sixth. Fourth inning started quickly and then unraveled, as you mentioned, in the sixth. The fifth inning was quick, just a six-pitch inning for Tucker. Helped out by the double play. Two and two. Full count. Pay off to Hobson. 90 mile an hour fastball for a strikeout.
But it really was just five hitters in a row. Besides that, Tucker's been so good. Retired the three and the fifth on six pitches and gets to a 3-2 count right here, and he's been able to do that. Take that fastball, throw it to the upper part of the zone, or maybe just a little bit up and out of it. It just stays there. Charlotte's had a hard time making an adjustment except for the two home run swings.
Will Butcher is one for two. Nine strikeouts for Tucker against one walk. Oklahoma leads Army 8-1. That game is in the seventh inning, elimination game. A&M Stanford tonight. Sunk a diamond. That's going to be interesting, isn't it?
That will be. Yeah, it'll be good. A&M, who... made an impressive run through the SEC tournament. Stanford offense back at it again yesterday. Alberto Rios, who wasn't hardly playing at the beginning of the year. Grand slam yesterday, ends up as a Pac-12 pitcher of the year. I think we get a pitch clock violation here.
Really hard when the pitch clock isn't visible, as it's not here at Doug Kinsmore Stadium.
I think next year it has to be. It instituted it. It didn't have to be for the first few years. Next year it does. I don't really know why it's not here. I mean, you got a massive digital board. It's just a lot easier on everybody if you can see it somewhere.
Oh. Make sure the cameras still work.
I just heard a camera's feelings over there.
I'd have to recalibrate. Swing and a miss for Butcher, strikeout number 10. And before that strikeout pitch, Mr. Rawlings coming right into your living room.
Uh-oh. You want to come back with. He went rifled into the dugout. Tucker does what he's done pretty consistently today. Same thing, elevated fastball, back-to-back strikeouts here in the sixth.
Eli Wiesner's got his fourth home run of the season, a pinch hit three-run shot in the nine hole in the fourth. Gave Charlotte its first lead of this game in a count 1-1. We were joking with Robert Woodard before he came on camera. Good job calling for a home run ball. He said, no, I just told him to hit a double. Overachiever. Winner stays alive. We'll play at noon again tomorrow against the loser of tonight's Orange matchup. Swing and a miss, strikeout number 11. Tucker K's the side in the sixth.
That's his best fastball of the day. Braden Tucker getting better as this goes on. Strikes out the side, the last one on a 94-mile-an-hour fastball to the seventh. Charlotte still leads it.
Break free from overpriced wireless with Boost Mobile. Switch to Boost and get a free Samsung Galaxy A23 5G phone with the power of America's largest 5G networks. Switch to Boost and get a free Samsung Galaxy A23 phone. Boost Mobile, unleash your power.
Oh, Florence. That's Stefania, our host.
Yeah, we stayed in a room in her place, and every morning she'd make us coffee.
She was always like, you should go here.
Whenever she got really excited about something, she would like, oh.
That's how we knew our plans were good for the day.
Is that KFC chicken sandwich spicy?
Sinfully.
I'd do anything for one.
Anything.
Gotcha one.
Order any KFC sandwich online till July 2nd for Diablo 4 reward.
YouTube TV is more than cable for less than cable. And who doesn't like more? Just ask anyone who loves basketball. And they'll tell you. There's no such thing as too much of it. Watch more games at once with MultiView on YouTube TV. YouTube TV, it's more than cable for $600 less than cable. Try it for free.
Beautiful's back out there.
Yeah, and Beautiful's been really good. Two-run double in the third. That's the only blemish so far. Stuff kind of started to play down a little bit third and the fourth. Now stuff's playing back up. Right out the split. Got a swing and miss on that. Nine strikeouts, just one walk for Wyatt Hudepohl, All-Conference USA this year. Robert Woodard talked about not easy to take him out of the ballgame. He's over 100, now 104, and back out there for the seventh.
He gets the bottom third of the Lipscomb order. I would think if it was the top of the order after 102, they probably would have gone up 10.
Yeah.
Combined 1-for-6. Will Lee's got the only hit among this trio. Scooped up by Stallman. One down. Has Campbell scored yet?
Scored one. I got bases loaded, two outs in the seventh right now. Uh-oh, I think they just scored four. We are tied. Grand slam.
Campbell's got their humps now. To the left side. Dragom gets rid of it quickly. Two down. That game in the mid-state. We got regionals in all regions of the Palmetto State. Here in Clemson, Columbia, and down in Conway. Two down for Will Lee. Came to Nashville to play for Lipscomb by way of Wharton County Community College. It was a 330 hitter last year in JUCO ball. One and two. As a pitcher, if you recognize the wide strike zone, how easy was it?
Keep on going. I mean, if you know that there's some give, whether it's up, down, in, or out, that's when you start changing plan a little bit.
2-2 from Hudepohl. Lifted to left. Blake Jackson is there. It's a 1-2-3 inning worked by Wyatt Hudepohl. Needed just eight pitches. Quick work. Time to stretch to Clemson.
I walk along the city streets you used to walk along with me. And every step I take recalls how much in love we used to be. Oh, how can I forget you when there is always something there to remind me.
Here it goes. I talk to my plants like they're babies.
Do you?
Yes, I do, don't I? Oh, my little babies. Oh, you need some water, babies.
Hey, you don't have to get that personal to get the State Farm personal price plan. It just helps you create an affordable price. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
Here for the Dunkin' Run campaign commercial. It's a great deal. A large coffee, a donut for a buck. I mean, it's pretty cool. So I thought it'd be like authentic and meta. Yes, I'm doing the commercial, but am I doing the commercial? You know, I don't do commercials. You know, I'm a real actor. This is an art form for me.
I do know you departed.
I departed.
Were you in the Departed?
I'm Matt Damon.
No, yeah, I love him.
Some of his work.
He's got a really consistent career, I think.
Yeah.
Time for a Dunkin' Run. Get a $1 donut with any medium or larger coffee.
Time for our Capital One rewarding performance. Two outs and two on in the fourth inning. Eli Wiesner called on to pinch hit. And he squeezed this one right out of the ballpark to give Charlotte the lead.
A little bit selfish. Robert Wood was just looking for a double right there. Instead, he rides it out to right center. They get a two-run shot off the bat of Jack Dragom later in that inning. All five runs for Charlotte. Scored in the fourth, and that has held up so far.
That's good coaching.
Yeah.
Braden Tucker hasn't made many mistakes in this game. The home runs, sure, but got unlucky by hitting Caden Hobson with a pitch. Two strikes and two outs in the fourth to extend that. And after striking at the side in the sixth, Blake Jackson greets him with a leadoff single in the seventh. That's hit number three today for the Charlotte left fielder.
Have yourself a day. Three hits and a walk. Blake Jackson's reached all four times. Same thing he did his first time up. Just wait on it, take it the other way. After punching out the side in the sixth, Braden Tucker now gives up a leadoff single and faces this guy that got him last time. Dead center. looked like maybe a changeup. The Dragon was just waiting on it. Came back over the middle of the plate, rides it out to the biggest part of the ballpark. 390 to center, hit a 392, but that was just far enough. Dragon's 2-for-3. I like that Braden Tucker doesn't wear the watch on his wrist. He just ties it around the belt. I think I would have done the same thing. I wouldn't want anything. Want anything on either one of my arms. You can't put it on your throwing arm anyway, but it's easy. Just peek down. Doesn't like that one, so go to the next. I think there's like a skip button on there. Nope. Next. Think you can play games on it, like that old Nokia phone, play Snake?
Time.
Gotta finish my board. Runner goes, pitch is high. The throw to second is just a little late. And Jackson now 10-13 on the bases. Jackson now the first in this Charlotte lineup to go double-digit stolen bases this year. That is 10th of the year. Now we'll get a visit to the mound from Austin Kelly. We have game 2 of the NBA Finals tomorrow at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, and ABC, ESPN Deportes, and ESPN Radio. Jimmy Butler in the Heat are in the Mile High City, squaring off against the Joker and the Nuggets. Joker's triple-double led Denver to the Game 1 win. Coverage tips with NBA Countdown at 7:30. So you get your establishment of choice tomorrow night. Watch Game 2 of the Finals after we finish with Game 2, like 9-ish.
Ish.
Go to the Esso Club. We could end up at Walk-Ons.
Where we're going
to
be.
Oh, yeah. We got 2 good options. Forgot what the count was. Dragon punched out on a pitch just off the plate. And that is K number 12 for Braden Tucker. So I got a question for you.
Okay.
Cam Fisher, the nation's home run leader, coming to plate. If you were to judge Bill McGuire's strike zone via TrackMan, it has been wide and it has been low. We call the majority of our games in the SEC where the strike zone has now mirrored TrackMan for.
Yeah, it's a lot closer. It's a lot closer to a major league zone.
In the college game, would you rather have the TrackMan strike zone or Bill McGuire's strike zone?
This one. Honestly, I think maybe it's a little bit smaller than what we've seen today, but I mean, college kids don't have the skill level of guys in the big league, so I don't know that you need exactly the same zone. I think a little bit of give makes sense.
McGuire worked the Missouri Valley Conference tournament last week. Cam Fisher 0-for-3, 3 strikeouts. I agree with you. I just think that what we have now is lack of consistency. Now, maybe it's always been there.
Yeah, I mean, one of your challenges is not everybody has TrackMan. And so if you're going to go back and kind of grade and say this is where we want to be, it's not always going to be apples to apples, league to league, ballpark to ballpark.
Got kicked away by Kelly, and Blake Jackson moves to third.
That's the easy one for the runner to see. If it goes straight behind the catcher, sometimes you can't tell depth, but side to side, the runner can see that one. Jackson steals second, now moves to third on a wild pitch. Now Lipscomb forced to bring the infield in, down three here in the seventh.
Ruled a wild pitch. Fisher looking at a 3-1 count. Leads Division I with 30 long balls. And there's ball four. A bat flip on a walk.
He just happened to be going down to first base. It's been a rare 2 days for Cam Fisher. You feel like if Charlotte can win this one, he may be running into one here tomorrow.
Twelve strikeouts against two walks. Tucker sitting at 105 pitches. There is action in the Lipscomb bullpen. Double barrel action for the Bisons, including Joey Mitchell, the lefty. Alex Brewer on the right side. Said I want to stay in the game.
Sometimes they don't always listen when you say that. Matt Myers out. Charlotte's patient. There haven't been too many of them today. And Lipscomb not too far behind. 343 walks coming into the regional. But today's been a little bit tougher because Tucker's been filling the zone up.
Here's Jack Cunningham. He's 1-for-3. Infield can move back now with a runner at first. There goes Fisher. Swing and a miss. No throw to second. We'll take the double play away. I got to come in again. Austin Kelly behind the plate hadn't thrown out a runner all year, so two bags here in the seventh for Charlotte. Easy pickings. One and one. Infield in, does that change your approach as a pitcher?
No, not really. I think you still got to go to your best stuff. For Tucker, though, I mean, he's now over his season high in pitches. Threw 106 earlier this year. That is 109th and should be deep enough to score another Charlotte run.
Up on the paw, catch made. Here comes Jackson. And Charlotte takes a 6-2 lead. Sack fly for Cunningham.
What'd you ask earlier? How many runs today?
Yep. Not there yet.
Nope.
And that'll do it for Braden Tucker. What an effort. I don't know what he just said, but he may have said, I'm just getting loose.
Tell you what, man, he was up 94 in the sixth. That was his best fastball of the day, but he gave him a chance. Two outs, nobody on, back in the fourth inning. Hits Caden Hobson with a two-strike breaking ball, and then Charlotte took advantage. Single home run. Until that last swing, that was all the score. But Jeff Forehand, you're going to be happy with the job that Braden Tucker did today. He will exit. New pitcher on for Lipscomb. They trail it by four.
To them, the whole world looks like an opportunity. One to be seized, built upon, and made better. for their sport and the people around it. To student athletes, every opportunity is a chance to change what could be and show the world what opportunity can do.
Wingstop has 12 flavors of chicken sandwich. In my day, we had one flavor, chicken. Now they have a garlic parmesan, a mango habanero, and a lemon pepper. Given the flavor at Wingstop.
We love our new home.
Great neighborhood, big backyard.
But the lamps. At least Geico makes bundling our home and car insurance easy.
We saved a lot.
For bundling made easy, go to geico.com.
12 strikeouts for Braden Tucker on a season-high 109 pitches. And the Bison's ace gave him 6 2/3. And now hands off to Joey Mitchell. Lefty from Murfreesboro, Tennessee. 36 strikeouts and 38 innings pitched. And his first pitch is fouled off. You know, if you look back at who Lipscomb put on the mound this weekend, that's a pretty good 1-2 punch. Logan Van Treek was fantastic against Clemson, and now Tucker with 12 strikeouts today. Nothing at two.
Left on left this year, Mitchell's been really slider heavy, and that's...
That one gets all the way to the backstop, and the runner comes home. And a wild pitch adds another for Charlotte. It's now 7-2.
I think that's a slider that got away. He's trying to throw the perfect one right there and just lets it go a little bit too early. 74 miles an hour, so it's definitely not a fastball. It's something that just slipped out of his hand. Nothing Keller can do back behind home plate. Fisher reached on a walk, stole base, advanced to third on the fly ball, now scores on the wild pitch.
One and two to Brandon Stallman. Payoff pitch is launched deep to right field. Another home run here. Clemson, that one off the roof. Stallman's ninth of the year.
Stallman took two fastballs that were borderline top of the zone. And just sat and waited on the breakable, and that's what you're going to get left on left with Joey Mitchell at some point. That one hangs in the zone, and that was a pretty left-handed swing. Watch this, no doubter.
Yep,
got that one. Just about clears the batting cages out in right field. It'll be a quick outing for Joey Mitchell.
And then the umpires went over and had a long conversation with Robert Woodard, I believe, regarding the bat flip from Stallman. And Lipscomb going right back to the bullpen.
You're doing it towards your own dugout. I got no problem with that. I mean, it's the point emphasis this year has been more if you're doing it towards the other dugout, and that gets everybody going. But it's something that the umpires are told to really look for this year. That one, if you hit it that far, I got no issue with that.
Why, Huitipel just didn't throw enough today?
I'd say that's an indication he's not done yet.
So here's what happened after the home run. Bill McGuire is a home plate umpire. Wanted to insert, say, hey, don't throw the bat. I guess.
Got to go jump. Hold on.
Good talk. I know the umpires are doing the job that they've been told to do, but I just think it was an overreaction to put these strict celebration limits in place anyway. I think it's what makes college baseball special and separates it. Well, I say separates it from the big leagues, but cool enough now the big leagues are doing
it. You're seeing plenty of that in the big leagues right now. If you're doing it, and if you're inciting the other side, you're doing it towards the other dugout, I get it. I mean, that can lead to other things, but if you're doing it with your own guys, I just don't really have an issue with it. Not that one, at least.
Alex Brewer out of Corydon, Tennessee, takes over, 17th appearance. The main issue, and Tony Vitello was kind of joking about it, he said, listen, that team we had last year was so historical, they made rules about our play, and so no props can be outside of the dugouts. If you want to put a fur coat on somebody or a daddy hat or crown or have them sit on a throne or what, all that has to happen inside your dugout. I didn't see any of that with Charlotte just now. All I saw was the bat throw.
Yeah, then kind of jump into everybody when you get in. Yeah, I didn't either.
Here's Austin Knight. What would your prop have been?
Never thought about that. My prop have been.
I think everybody should have their own prop.
Slab of bacon. Like the thick kind, though.
Yeah. I don't like country ham. I think it's too salty. But if you could just present me with a large ham on my way back into the dugout, I'd be a fan of that. Two hits for Knight now. Is it a wonder both of our picks were food related?
I was going to say, pork farmers everywhere rejoicing right now. They really want this to catch on.
Caden Hobson rips it through the right side. Knight will head to third. First hit for Hobson in this one. Charlotte got into the bullpen, started doing real damage.
I feel like you astutely said that early in this game. Whoever gets in the bullpen first probably going to go on a run. And it's, you got clubs that are going back-to-back days. Both had to use their bullpen pretty extensively yesterday. We're starting to see the effects of that right now.
Kyle, this ain't no hobby.
You do take this serious.
Here's Will Butcher, 8-hole hitter. Breaking ball for a strike, nothing in one.
Campbell has a lead, by the way.
Greg or the Camels?
Both. Greg's undefeated.
Looks like Colstow's bounced back okay. Grand slam in the first, 10-2 lead in the eighth. Two and one. I think the coolest prop, by the way, I saw this season was a disco ball helmet that Alabama's rocking. Blown away.
You got a walk-off win last night.
Good crowd at the Joe. Ball four, and Charlotte's loaded the bases.
He's on. Austin Knight at third. Caden Hobson at second. Will Butcher now at first. Eli Wiesner will get a chance to come to the plate again. The last time up, it was a three-run home run to right center.
Foul territory for Lundgren.
I don't think this one's got the distance. Remember that? Remember that? It's one of the greatest movie lines ever. More runs for Charlotte. They're in control to the eighth at Clemson. It's 8-2, 49ers.
Stacy!
I'm the sizzle of this promposal. Tonight,
Stacey!
Sparks are gonna fly.
Kyle?
And while Romeo over here is trying to look cool, things are about to heat up.
Uh-oh.
Darn it, Kyle!
And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, you can end up paying for this yourself.
Sorry, Mr. Sanchez.
Really?
So get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
That's a hard note.
I like to move it, you like to move it!
We're reinventing our network.
Move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it.
Fast, reliable, perfectly orchestrated. The United States Postal Service.
Subway just keeps getting better. Break it down, Candace.
They got world-class bakers to develop their tastiest bread yet. This truly makes the Subway Series a dream team. You know about that, Chuck.
Yeah, I was the bread of that team, too.
Try the Subway Series menu. Their tastiest refresh yet. The Subway Series is getting an upgrade. The new number 19, the Pickleball Club. Who knew the Subway Series could get even better?
Me. I knew.
Maybe you should host a commercial then.
Sure, okay. Subway Series just keeps getting better.
Grab your phone, hold it up to your TV. I promise it'll make sense. There it is. Scan that thing, and that'll eventually take you to a place where you can find Squeeze Play, around-the-clock multi-game coverage. ESPN Plus subscribers can access expanded coverage with Squeeze Play. White Utipol is still in the game.
In fact, he was warming up in between innings.
112 pitches deep. Going to get on Jeremy Mills here in a second. He'll help out. We saw a couple of deep performances yesterday. Including Paul Skeens.
Maybe a surprise that LSU went with Skeens yesterday, but they didn't need anybody else. 9-inning complete game, punched out 12.
Let's talk with Ben McDonald about that. He's calling the Baton Rouge Regional with Dave Neal. He thought it was a sign as much of an indicator of the confidence or lack thereof of LSU's bullpen. Snared over at third by Stallman. And that last pitch at Skeens through that was 1-1. Good crowd, good energy. So Skeens was certainly feeling it.
Yeah. If you're over 100 pitches bumping 1-1, I don't care if it's a first or over 100. Caleb Ketchup hit it on the button again, but just right at Stallman. This Charlotte defense has been pretty solid today.
Ketchup deserves a better line than he's had today. Some borderline pitches go against him, then he hits one on the screws that ends up in Stallman's glove. Here's Alex Vergara. Mentioned the home run record for this Lipscomb team. Sitting at 109. The previous record was 66. 1-2 now.
That's
three different players have passed the original single season home run record. That was just 17. strike out on the 120th pitch of the night.
Well, that one was important early, and Utapol still got it. The breaking ball has kind of been the separator today for the big right-hander. He's stayed around because of that. Fastball was good, but this has really been the key. Now a career high in pitches for Wyatt Utapol. That last was his 120th, and he's still going.
Mason Lundgren has a two-run double to his name. Career high in pitches for Utapol, and Lundgren comes up with a two-out single. Trace Wilhoit singled back in the second. At the end of the bat, foul, nothing and one. Did you ever play the trumpet?
No, I played the saxophone for about 2 weeks. And I wasn't really built for that. My mom made me take a year of piano lessons. I got through that all right.
Did you retain any of it?
No.
Not even the first few notes of the Pink Panther theme?
Da-da-da-da. No, I could probably get there.
Chopsticks?
No, I already told you no.
Yeah. How about Harold Faltermeyer and the XLF theme?
That one I got.
Shift on for Charlotte again. 2-1 count to Trace Wilhoit.
Seen a lot of these so far this weekend. We're seeing more around college baseball, but it feels like Charlotte shifts more than about anybody we've seen this year.
Ever? Three and two. Pitch 128. Curveball. Tomahawked foul. Save the Dippin' Dots. My man ran out of his shoe. Did you see that?
Did he? Well, he didn't break stride. He was on a mission.
Here's a 3-2. Got him looking. Wyatt Utapol with 11 strikeouts, a career high in pitches thrown. That's got to be it for the right-hander. And if it is, he leads with a 6-run lead.
Hey, I'm Jake from State Farm.
You know, it's really scary.
Popcorn with no butter.
No, getting insurance. I mean, what if the jargon makes me feel alone and in the dark?
Hey, at State Farm, we're there for your what-ifs.
Ah! Sorry. Is that seat taken?
Get on up here, buddy. Let's go. Let's go.
One. Yeah, threw my cup of ale.
I saw. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
I like to move it, you like to move it.
We're reinventing our network.
Move it. I like to move it, I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it. I like to move it, you like to move it.
Fast. Reliable, perfectly orchestrated. The United States Postal Service. Move it.
That's a pretty tight spot.
Watch this.
Your Buick parks itself. That's so you.
Of course you know where we're going. That's so you.
Kinda got a sixth sense.
And a head-up display.
They're here.
At the heart of every Buick SUV is you.
Get 2.49% APR and no monthly payments for 90 days. Plus, current eligible non-GM owners get $750 purchase allowance on 2023 Buick Encore GX models.
Here's Noah Thompson, senior at a Louisville Male High School, two-time A-Sun Pitcher of the Week. He's been the Sunday starter for the Bisons this season. Third-team All-Conference, 6-3 with a 4.07 ERA. And sitting at 55 strikeouts on the year.
I mean, you would think Thompson would have started tomorrow if Lipscomb could get to that point, but you got to get through this one first. See if you can throw a zero up right here. That offense can give a few a ride in the ninth, give Lipscomb a chance. But the left-hander over the course of the year, it's an upper 80s fastball. Curveball, a slider, but primarily curveball. More changeups to righties.
Blake Jackson leads things off. Charlotte sent 9 to the plate in the 7th. Jackson has 3 hits in this game. I had this discussion with Tim Kirkjian a couple of years ago. What do you consider batting around?
10.
Why 10 instead of 9?
Because it's around. I don't know. I just. What did he say?
It's irrelevant. I just. I'll share irrelevant. It with you
he
after
brought
we're
his
done.
Name up. What did he say?
He said 10 as well. And I have a hard time disagreeing with Tim Kirkjian on anything.
He's a Hall of Famer.
Except for this. Fly ball to left. And this will be Vergara, one down. All right, let me ask you a question.
10.
When you walk out your front door,
okay,
and you walk around the block,
I take one extra step.
You go to your neighbor's
always,
house, or you go back in your
step.
Door?
Yep. Always.
You're an overachiever, and you're a liar. Jack Dragum's got a two-run home run to his name. Dragum struck out looking in the 7th. Outfield is playing Dragum the opposite way with Vergara shading towards right center and Berg staying true and left. I don't imagine the wind is going to stop blowing out to right today. And that could lead us to a couple of long balls tonight. Long run for Vergara, and he is there.
It's not howling. It's definitely helping, but it's not howling. We got a little bit of swing and miss tonight, too. Dolander Caden Grice for a nightcap. That's not a bad way to go out.
Caden still at the ballpark?
No, he's not where he was, at least.
Here's Cam Fisher. Knoxville native out of Hardin Valley Academy. You remember the home run that was hit in the Tennessee-Charlotte game last night to right field that the Tony Vitello doppelganger dropped in the first row of the seats?
Yep.
That was his high school pitching coach. He's out there with his high school head coach. Just another reminder, coach is very much a do as I say, not as I do profession. Base is empty, two down, 2-1. Cam Fisher sitting on 30 home runs. Breaking ball stayed up. Two out walk. Second time Fisher's been walked. And here's Jake Cunningham. I feel like Magic Stick is the perfect walk-up song.
Is that what this song is? Yeah, it sounds great.
Two. Throw to first, almost got the right field.
This one gets over Lundgren's head. It's going to roll around for a while down that right field line.
There goes the runner, and the pitch is looped into left field. Fisher headed to third on a full sprint. And the 49ers have runners at first and third with two down in the eighth.
Jake Cunningham turning his day around. Struck out the first two times and singled. Sack fly that scored one in his fourth at bat. Now just waited for a breaking ball to come right back into that barrel. Shoots it out to left. And Charlotte's got more action here in the eighth, trying to add on.
Breaking news, rain delay in Fayetteville, Santa Clara and Arizona. Postponed by the tarp being on the field. Hello. Shallow left. Berg racing in. Catch up back. Berg lays out and knocks it down. A run is already in.
Was a base hit, and part of it too is Caleb Ketchup was not on the second base side. It wasn't a full shift, but where he started, he had a long way to go. So Berg went back then, had to come all the way in. He's there in plenty of time, but has to lay straight out. But if Ketchup is playing normal shortstop position, he's camped under this thing. Instead, they were pulled to the pole side right there. He couldn't get there, and Charlotte adds another.
Austin Knight swings at the first, sends a ground ball to short. And that'll end the eighth, but not before Charlotte tacks another one on. 9-2 lead as we head to the ninth. Last chance for Lipscomb.
The NCAA Baseball Regionals are presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
I'm your overly competitive brother.
Check. Psych.
And I'm about to steal this game from you, just like I stole Kelly Carter in high school, huh?
You got no game. Dude, that's a foul.
And now you're ready to settle a score. Game over. And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, well, you can end up paying for all this yourself. So get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem. Yeah, like me.
Thanks, bro.
Take a lap, rookie.
Real mature.
This isn't Charmin. No wonder I don't feel as clean.
Hurry up, Dad.
You've been in there forever.
I'm trying. This cheap stuff is too thin.
I told you not to get the other toilet paper.
Here's Charmin Ultra Strong.
Ah, my bottom's been saved. Woohoo!
With its diamond weave texture, Charmin Ultra Strong cleans better with fewer sheets and less effort.
What's everybody waiting for? This?
Okay, hon. We know you're clean. We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin?
That's a pretty tight spot.
Watch this.
Your Buick parks itself. That's so you.
Of course you know where we're going. That's so you.
Kind of got a sixth sense.
And a head-up display.
They're here.
At the heart of every Buick SUV is you. Get 2.49% APR and no monthly payments for 90 days. Plus, current eligible non-GM owners get $750 purchase allowance on 2023 Buick Encore GX models.
Welcome back to the NCAA Baseball Regionals presented by Capital One. 1-0 game tonight. Number one, Clemson. Number two, Tennessee. At 6 o'clock Eastern on ESPN2. And whoever can hold on in this one will come back tomorrow for a noon start against the loser of tonight's game. Regional final scheduled for Sunday at 6 Eastern. Then an if-necessary game Monday, if necessary. Here's Clark Dearman, second appearance of the regional. 2-0 on the year with a 5-0-8.
At least as they're scheduled, Lipscomb will go lefty-lefty righty in this inning. Dearman's been really good against lefties this year, a ton of sliders.
Austin Kelly at the plate, he's 0-2. Ball, two strikes. Kelly's looking for his first hit. He homered twice in a game against Auburn on March 3rd. Also had four hits against Louisville a month later against some big-time opponents. Foul territory. Catcher can't find it. What happened there between Hobson and
Wiesner? He's got to go get that ball. And that's a really hard play for a catcher, and they both got to go about the same direction, but that's the first baseman's ball the entire time, and there's no reason to look. Just go get it, call it. He's got to go a ways, don't get me wrong, but he stopped way short of this and ends up hitting on the grass right in front of him. That one's got to be caught.
You should add to the equation the fact that the wind is blowing towards right and was bringing it closer to Wiesner and away from Hobson. One, two. 12th strikeout for Charlotte pitchers today. After Hudepohl notched 11.
He just stuck a fastball in a perfect spot right there. Dearman will throw you more sliders and fastballs to left-handers, and I think that's exactly what Kelly was looking for there.
Here's Jake Berg. He is 0-3 in this game. Was 1-4 yesterday, and he swings at the first offering. Shallow left field, Jackson and Stallman backing up. Two down. And the Bisons, after ASUN regular season championship and an ASUN tournament championship, are down to their last out. They'll send up a pinch hitter here in Bauk's space. This is Chaz Bertolani. First pitch upstairs to Bertolani, 1-0. Out of Johns Creek High School in Alpharetta, Georgia. A lot of folks from Johns Creek in the area this weekend. 2-0. Bertolani started 39 games last year, catcher by trade. But hadn't gotten to start since May 20th, 2-1. Three and one. to short. Gobbled up by Dragom, and that'll do it. Third game of the regional is in the books, and this is a 9-2 Charlotte win, sending Lipscomb home for the season.
Started on the mound today. Wyatt Hudepohl hung in there, gave up two in the third, and then after that, there was a bunch of zeros. Gave this offense a chance to get going, and this offense got going. 5 and 4 to take their first lead, then 3 more in the 7th, 1 in the 8th, a couple of home runs mixed in, 3 total today for Charlotte. It'll end the season for Lipscomb, but anytime you end it in the postseason, that's a pretty good year.
Hudepohl was the workhorse today. 129 pitches. Nobody has thrown more in a single game in this NCAA tournament. It comes after a long weekend of work last week at the Conference USA tournament. Hudepohl threw 129. Skeens for LSU threw 124. Tanner Hall of Southern Miss 123. And a couple of others threw 119 each. You think the workload that he had last weekend, plus the fact he was pushed back a day going on Saturday, this is going to be his only appearance regardless?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, if he got past 50 pitches, which he absolutely was going to, then, yeah, this was it. And for Charlotte, I mean, it's you got to win today or you don't play tomorrow. So you kind of do everything you absolutely need to do. The advantage is they rested the vast majority of their bullpen. Dierman comes in. He can definitely work tomorrow, and the rest of their bullpen should be ready to go.
9-2 is the final. Squeeze play is underway with Chris Budd and Mike Rooney. Why isn't Chris Burke working?
He's got the late shift. By late shift, he starts in like 6 minutes, so you'll see him shortly.
Thought maybe he was out smile shopping. Clemson at Tennessee at 6. That's on ESPN2. And Charlotte stays alive. We'll take on the loser of that one tomorrow at noon. And the regional finals Sunday at 6 o'clock Eastern here at Doug Kinsmore Stadium in Clemson. The winner of this regional matches up with the winner of the Auburn regional. It's got a good beat, and I can dance to it. Now, Wyatt Hudepohl was fantastic in this one. And you know what? When you throw 129 pitches, not only do you get the win, but you get to talk to us. I mean, what an honor. Wyatt joins us now. Wyatt, congratulations. That was man, you've had heck of a workload between the conference tournament and then 129 today. How you feeling, brother?
I feel great. The Niners got to win. That's all that matters.
You had a couple of chances to talk with Robert Woodard about going back out there. What was it that pushed you back out there in both the 7th and 8th innings?
These guys, man, they're making the plays. Eli Wiesner came in big with that pinch hit home run. I mean, you see it. We're working all around. We're making the right plays, and I want to put as far as I can to help us win tomorrow for the guys moving forward.
I talked to Woody before this game, and he said one of the keys today, you know, the adrenaline's going to be there early, but one of the keys was landing a breaking ball. And you had control of the breaking ball really the entire game. How did that play into what the success was today?
Honestly, I disagree with you a little bit. I didn't feel like I had any feel at all. Honestly, probably the most balls I've thrown this year, but I had to compete, make pitches when they matter the most, and help the team win.
Go back and watch the film, bud, because if you didn't have any feel with that one today, then I want to see the good one. Because it was, I mean, there was a lot of swing and miss on it. Maybe you didn't land as many as you wanted to, but there was a ton of swing and miss early in this game on it.
Yes, sir. Well, I appreciate that.
Talk to us about the team before we let you go. You mentioned the pinch hit for Wiesner. That was a huge moment in this game. Yes, what's the belief level for this 49er squad right now?
Oh, you know, we've competed all year long. We put the schedule the right way so we can compete at these moments right here. I mean, these boys got it. We've been through it all, and we're ready to go.
And we appreciate your time. Congratulations. Go get some ice, brother.
Good work today. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, guys.
Wyatt Hudepohl with the win after 8 innings of 2-run baseball. He struck out 11. He walked only one. Charlotte's season will continue. They'll play tomorrow at noon here at Clemson and wait to see who their opponent will be tonight. Robert Woodard with a nice ovation for his starting pitcher, Wyatt Hudepohl. Their final score again, Charlotte 9, Lipscomb 2. We'll be back at 6 Eastern on ESPN2 for a big orange matchup. It's Tennessee and Clemson later today. Thanks, everybody.
Number 32, Kyle Hornsby.
This tight end inside the
the 30. Touchdown. Michaela Burgess.
An incredible finish by Holmes.
The NCAA and its member schools offer nearly 500,000 college athletes a path to go pro in something other than sports. Learn more at NCAA.org.
Is that KFC chicken sandwich spicy?
Sinfully.
I'd do anything for one.
Anything.
Gotcha, one.
Order any KFC sandwich online till July 2nd for Diablo 4 reward.
This is Sadie. She's on Verizon, and she has the new My Plan, where she gets exactly what she wants and only pays for what she needs. She picks only the perks she wants and saves on every one, all with an incredible new iPhone. Get iPhone 14 Pro.